Hey, it's Cable here from One-to-One Fitness and Fitbody Bootcamp, and here's an interesting fitness and nutrition tip for you that maybe you weren't aware of or never thought of. You know, the world, believe it or not, is actually making it very difficult for you to lose weight or get in shape, and here's how. So, and it's actually has more to do with your physiology and actually how your body works on a physiological level than anything else. So, have you ever noticed that movies over the last 20 years have gotten a lot more action-packed, they've gotten a lot more violent, they've shown a lot more gory details, you know, the news is really featuring horrible stories and things that are actually really, really disturbing. You know, and if you notice this about our world today, it's actually, believe it or not by accident. You know, so what researchers discovered and know very well, and the media has used this for a long time to their advantage, this is how they actually capture your attention. Because by humans, there's a strong physiological response that occurs when we are exposed to these types of materials or these types of images or situations. So believe it or not, when we are exposed to bad news, gory, action-packed, highly sensitive scenes, it actually stimulates an adrenal response or that fight-or-flight survival mechanism that our body used to use us to save us from imminent danger. So even visually, just seeing these things, it actually still stimulates a response in an area of our brain called the amygdala that actually stimulates your body's heightened sensitivity and activates our flight-or-fight response that allows us to increase concentration and ultimately pay attention to what's going on. The media actually uses this. Now, if you notice behind me here in my home, I have all these pictures of movies. It's no secret that I'm kind of a movie guy. And, you know, when I have some downtime, I spend a bunch of time watching movies. And recently, I actually watched a study that talks about big blockbuster Hollywood movies and one of the things that they're doing with the trailers for their big Hollywood blockbuster films. So they actually produce multiple trailers for different movies, and they subject them to different focus groups and stuff to find out which trailer is received best by their target audience. But this goes even further, and there's a whole science component to it. Some Hollywood studios are actually within their focus groups using scientists and researchers to actually measure brainwave response of the people watching the trailer to see what heightens their brain activity as they watch the trailer for this movie. So it's a really amazing and scientific approach that they're using to actually capture your attention. So it's the same thing again, where they're stimulating the amygdala of the brain that allows you to concentrate and be sensitive and pay attention to these things and ultimately capture your attention. Now, what does this have to do with fitness or weight loss? I mean, what movies, the news, and all that things have to do with me losing weight, getting in shape, and feeling the way I want? Well, that's actually a very interesting question. The body, if you don't know, functions on what's called negative feedback loops. So when our physiology greatly changes for any reason, your body may start to sense after a while that this is an unusual response or not typical for our body. So what happens is it uses what's called a negative feedback loop to downregulate or lessen the response to these types of things. So the more bad news we watch, the more highly action movies we want, we start to notice that we become desensitized. We have a harder time to focus and concentrate. It's not as interesting. We don't pay as much attention, which is why that trend continues of getting more action-packed, more gory, more dramatic. So when the physiology of your body is basically down-regulating so that we're not as sensitive to these types of things. Now, all of this impacts the same physiology associated with weight loss. You're exercising, you're dieting, you think you're eating right, but ultimately, because your body is so stressed from these stress hormones and that down-regulation, your metabolism now doesn't function as well, and you're fighting a bit of an uphill battle. Which is why, when it comes to fitness and nutrition, 80%, unfortunately, from A to B isn't good enough. We're wired for instant gratification. We want to get there as fast as possible. We don't want it to happen slowly. So we need to basically be picture perfect in order for our body to respond. Now, because of the downregulation or change of our physiology based on the stressors that we're faced in everyday life around us, our metabolism functions even less efficiently. We need to be even more precise in our eating. So this is why, as a trainer, I firmly believe that for the first couple weeks, for sure, you need to be weighing and measuring your food. It needs to meet a specific mathematical ratio. We need to adjust that ratio ever so subtly to make sure that your body's responding. If we do this for a few weeks and you're still not getting the response you want, then we need to look at healing the body and some of these things that potentially have downregulated hormonally, etc. And this is where cleansing, you know, things like cleansing the colon, cleansing the liver, improving the health and those things that clean up the garbage and kind of protect us from stress in life will greatly enhance our metabolism and ultimately our results. So if you've been struggling to get results, lose weight, or get in shape for a long period of time, stop, start avoiding the news, don't watch the news, try to avoid the bad news, the bad